Hello again. Okay, on this new version, you got a new tab here. Process some monocular video. You now have this, I'm calling it SLAHMR. But let me say a couple of things about it. It's probably the best result that you're going to have using any of those three, but it's extremely slow. For example, WHAM can have a good result, basically no jitter, and it runs faster than for the humans. But SLAHMR, it gets also a very good result, but it takes too much to finish. For example, I executed a while ago about 100 of frames, and it took almost an hour to get the result. If you use 300 frames, probably it's gonna take more than 3 hours. That's a huge problem. So I think the best way to use it is to select a part of the video that you want, and that specific part that you need to have a better result, use it with SLAHMR. What I suggest to do is run first WHAM. If I have a specific part that is not fast, it doesn't detect fast movement. Also, WHAM doesn't detect fast movements. Only for the humans detects fast movement, but it has jitters. So you have to analyze well which part you're going to run. So let me do a quick explanation about installation. And for the humans, you have the VM for it, WHAM. The same thing, you have the VM for it, for SLAHMR. For now, you also have to create a VM specific for SLAHMR. And you have to install it like usual for the other parts. You don't need to install any one of the other two to use SLAHMR. You just have to install the VM of SLAHMR to use SLAHMR. If you want to use the WHAM, you have to install the VM for the WHAM, and the same thing for the humans, in case you don't have it yet. Okay, so the installation, you have to do each part, the create the VM, then click on the install PyTorch. It will pop up a window. You have to finish, to wait for it to finish. Then the start detection, wait for it to finish. You can close then the window. The same thing for this part and this part. After doing all of these steps, you will have to download. You can download at any moment and download the dependencies. It's a Google Drive link from the creators of the project. It's not my Google Drive. And you download the files, about 4 gigabytes. And after downloading this file, you can use the import SLAHMR dApps to load the file that you downloaded. And it will take a little bit to finish because it's about 4 gigabytes. It takes a while to do the unzipping. And last part, in case you didn't have the SMPL FBX on any other solution, you have to get it. I'm almost sure if you already use WHAM or for the humans, you don't have to import the SMPL FBX again. And if you need to import it, it will be red. In this case, it's not red, so you don't need to worry about it. The other parts, not every one of them are going to be red because I couldn't do yet the check for everything. So this part for the VM is done, and let me do a little explanation on how to process the data. The thing is, you select a video. After selecting a video, you will have the path here, and loading the path, it will detect the frame per second and the start and end of the frame. Let me load another one just to show an example. Pay attention to this FPS. When I load the other video that has 60 frames per second, it detects automatically, and the start basically is the end frame. And why this is important? The FPS is important so you can have the same FPS as the result. If you don't want to have 60 FPS as the result, you can change it to 30, for example. Probably it will process faster. And press update and execute the SLAHMR. Okay, let's see, for example, if you wanna run this video, but you don't want to run everything because it will take a long time. I did this load video on screen so you can see more easily where you're going to start and end the process. So let me press the load video and you have this image plane on your 3D view, and you can start looking what part is important for you. For example, let me see, I want to detect this part, it's the frame 5, so I put here start at frame 5, and I want just about this moment, it's the frame 61, so the end will be frame 61. It's 56 frames. I press update, so I'm going to update the preferences for the execution. It is going to process starting at 5, finishing at 61 at 60 frames per second. So I can press now execute SLAHMR. I won't do that because it will take probably more than half an hour to do this. And after it finishing, you are able to see the process on the console, this on my right side, and it will take a long. It doesn't show the how much time left you have to wait. So you have to wait for it finish to unlock, because when it's processing, the Blender is become freeze. You have to wait it for it to unfreeze to be able to go to the next part. After finishing the process, you can import the same way as for the humans, and when you can choose a character, because SLAHMR also detects multiple characters from the same video. And basically that's it. But one more thing, as you take too long to process, it would be nice to have this data to use in another occasion. So I created also the export and the import. The export is going to pack all the data that is created by SLAHMR, and it will save as a zip. So when you import the data, you have to select the zip that was exported, and it's going to recreate everything so you can use the import character. What I mean by that, even if you execute SLAHMR on Google Colab, you won't be able to import it just selecting a simple file. I plan to do an explanation on that, or to create another button for the Google Colab in the future. Keep watching, and I'll probably soon I'll have some instruction about that. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye.